They get a sense of involvement and they get a sense of feeling that history is relevant to them and to their lives, and they can begin to think about how concepts that are being presented to them affect not only the historical circumstances but affect the way they think about the world today. And they can insert themselves into the picture. They can imagine themselves in a different set of historical circumstances, but they can also relate what they're seeing in a different historical time to what they're experiencing in today's world and what they think the future might be like. I think higher learning through history is transformative in a way that not all subjects are. I think that history allows students to develop a way of thinking about the world which brings themselves into relationship with long-term trends, with the big questions that face humanity, in a way that allows them to think analytically about it, and allows them to relate those big themes to their own lives and to the small, practical, everyday things that happen around them. And it allows them to make relationships between things that happen in the past with the possible futures and with the present. So I also think history is an extremely flexible kind of subject because it allows you to draw in concepts and theory from all different fields, because history encompasses everything that happened before yesterday and every possible way of thinking about the world. But the discipline of history brings a certain kind of perspective and thinking technique and disposition, which I think allows students to think in new ways about that material. And once they've learned those kinds of ways of thinking, I think they never turn back. It affects the way they live the rest of their lives. And so it's not like learning a fact or a piece of information. It really changes the very people that they are.